Hello everyone, I'm Subramanian, a PhD student from the C-Design lab at Purdue University. I'm here today to present our work, Process AR, an augmented reality-based tool to create in-situ procedural 2D, 3D AR instructions. We developed this work along with my collaborators mentioned here. Today, if you want to learn a skill, especially a spatial one, you have three different popular media you can use. They are paper-based instruction, video instructions, and one-on-one instruction. In recent years, augmented reality has been explored as a possible alternative, but it is not widely adopted yet. To understand why, we must first understand the current limitation in creating such AR instructions. Here, we have a line representing the spectrum of reality with the real world on one end and the virtual world on the other. Augmented reality occupies a region somewhere in the middle. So, currently, to create instructions in AR, a subject matter expert with subject expertise will have to work together with the programmer with AR expertise. Alternatively, we developed Process AR to empower the subject matter expert to create AR instruction without the need for complicated programming directly. With Process AR, the subject matter expert can create AR instruction in situ without leaving the AR head-mounted device. Process AR allows its user to create both 2D and 3D AR content. It detects the objects in the real world with computer vision and spawns the corresponding virtual tools, which the user can interact with to create a 3D animation of the instruction. If the user desires, they can also capture the interaction with the physical object in a video and embed it onto embed it into the AR space. Currently, there are commercial AR authoring environments such as Microsoft Dynamics 365 and PTC's Euphoria Capture. Still, both these systems do not provide an in-situ authoring environment, which we realized was an important factor in determining the speed of content creation from our preliminary design study. These commercial tools also focus only on 2D AR and does not provide any support for creating complex 3D content. While not commercially available, research work such as Oda et al. And Loki published earlier explore the 3D content transfer from a remote location. Although these work are interesting, they are specifically targeted towards synchronous mode of instructional transfer. That is, a constant presence of a subject matter expert is required for instructional transfer in these mediums. To eliminate this constraint, an asynchronous medium must be developed, which these past work don't explore. Very recently, works such as AuthAR and Yamaguchi et al. Explore AR instructional authoring. These work assume the end user already knows how to use the tool they interact with and only focus on depicting instructions on where to use the tool. Thus, animation of tool manipulation aren't supported. Hence, Process AR was developed by understanding the limitation of such past work and addresses the design challenges that arise from the intersection of these limitations. We began our work with a formative interview conducted with subject matter experts from the industry, educators, and AR programmers to gain insight into the design space. We followed up the interview with a preliminary design study conducted on two groups of users, subject experts and novices. We ran the study on three spatial tasks, engine assembly, shelf installation, and bike repair. The expert study consists of 10 participants with 5 engine experts, 3 bike repair experts, and 2 woodworking experts. All experts were asked to create instructions in AR, video, and paper-based media. To validate the quality of instructions created in different media by experts, 16 novices were invited to perform the same task but using the instructions generated by the experts. The details of the results and observations are provided in the paper, but I just wanted to go over some interesting observations with you. The graph on the right represents the average amount of time it takes to author instructions from different media for experts. If you notice, the average amount of time for AR is it is about 15.6 minutes. The average time for both paper and video instructions are significantly higher. It is interesting because it was observed from the study that one reason for the increased time was during content transfer between mediums. That is, for authors to create both video and paper instruction, they first had to record and take pictures using a phone, which was then transferred to be worked on a desktop. Since the AR system was in situ, no transfer of content was necessary and thus was faster. The results from the study and the interview gave us some insight which were used to develop the design goals. It was observed that the experts were having trouble animating instruction involving flexible objects such as brake wires, for which the experts said they would prefer a video for such interaction. Thus, the goal to support multimedia was added. It was also observed that the novices were having trouble identifying where the next instruction would be rendered while viewing 3D AR instruction. Thus, one of the system's goals was to provide a feature to provide perspective awareness. Now, let us look at the system. This video shows a demonstration of the 3D authoring environment. The authoring users identifies all the tools and parts in the workspace. A modified computer vision algorithm helps process AR to identify the tools along with their positions in 3D space. Once all the objects are detected, the author can create instruction by simply grabbing the virtual objects and recording a 3D animation along with their voice. Once all instructions are completed, they were saved and transferred to a novice who can then view each instruction sequentially and follow to complete the task. We used an Oculus Rift paired with a Z Mini camera to create an AR see-through within the VR headset. We used the Unity game engine alongside Oculus SDK for system development. We also used the OpenCV for Unity plugin to set up computer vision algorithms. We used the famous You Look Only Once machine learning based computer vision algorithm for enabling Process AR to detect all the tools in the environment. We rely on pre-existing CAD models for representing virtual models. There are other 3D scanning based systems available to address the issue during the lack of availability of such CAD models. 2D authoring. Process AR allows users to import videos that capture their first person view, which is added into the AR space. The users can preview video and use the virtual marker to tag objects associated with the video instruction. Once tagging is done, each video is rendered on top of the corresponding object. In the novice mode, the users first detect the tools involved. Upon detection, the system renders the corresponding video. Novices can freely drag the footage within the AR environment and control video playback by simply looking towards and away from the screen. Navigation. To guide the novice user to the starting location of each instruction, Process AR tracks the author's movement and provides a navigation path within the workspace. Also, unlike 2D videos, following 3D content may be difficult due to the ambiguity in best viewing perspective. Process AR captures the author's point of view and renders the most appropriate perspective. We performed another study on 12 users to better understand the system by comparing it to another baseline AR authoring environment. The various features of Process AR and baseline system are depicted in the table. The results reveal Process AR to be a better system with statistically significant results in cognitive load, error reduction, and qualitative surveys. Please refer to a paper for further details. There were a few limitations identified in Process AR that has been highlighted here. As you might have noticed from the video clips, For the expert to author the content, they must first demonstrate with the virtual tool, then drop the controllers to interact with the physical tool to perform the task, then move to the next step. Hence, a controller-free environment would further enhance the user experience. Also, all the models displayed were static virtual models. That is, they do not provide a rich medium of animation. For example, animating the power drill spinning spindle isn't supported in the current version. Then, theoretically, it is also possible to use Process AR to create the AR content with the head-mounted display and transfer the created content to another AR-enabled device such as a phone or a tablet. But this hasn't been explored in this version. Finally, I would like to acknowledge the National Science Foundation for funding this work. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention.